Well, folks, we've made it to Redman Creek Corps of Engineer Park here in Southeast Tech. Hello, we're not in Texas, are we? In Southeast Missouri, and this is a Corps of Engineer Park, and it has 109 sites. There's a west side and an east side. We are on the west side this time. We did stay on the east side, and if you'd like to see a video of that, when we did a video of that, it's going to post that right up there, right there. See it? Right there it is. There it is.
Anyway, hit the subscribe button and click that notification bell to be alerted when our latest videos are posted.
This is where we're staying this time. This is Redman Campground West. This campsite, this campground only has 40 sites, 1 to 40 sites, but they are all full hookup and $24 a night. Very nice campground. And the sites are spread out. You don't have neighbors on top of you. It's a very nice laid out campground.
Going to start off with campsite number one, the back end site.
There are only 3 pull-throughs out of the 40. The rest are all back end, but they're all paved concrete pads. We have a lantern hanger, a nice grill for a fire or to cook on. Has a grate that adjusts top, up and down. And their restrooms are, they're just immaculate. And they're private. When you go in, it's an all-in-one, which means it has a shower and restroom all-in-one. This is their buddy site. Now, this one doesn't have 2 concrete pads. This is the buddy site. All of the sites that are in both the campgrounds, Redman East and Redman West, can be reserved on the same day. But one thing is they do not mark, like some campgrounds mark the reservations that are coming in that day. They don't do that at either of these campgrounds. So you might pull in here on the same day and think there's a lot still available, but you need to check it online to see exactly what is available before making your reservation. And if there's an additional cars in your party, there's places to park on the side, extra parking. And as you can see, the sites are very well spaced out. You're not crowded, you're not on top of your neighbor. And we really like that because we have a big dog and a little dog, and that gives us a lot of room to kind of let him out on a long lead while we're outside, and it's just nice. Here's another buddy site. I think they have 2 of those type sites here at this campground. This site right that we're passing now is site 28, and it goes from side to side. So across from that's 27, then 28, then 29, shoots back and forth across.
And the video really doesn't do a lot of justice. Most of these sites are actually pretty darn level.
Yeah, and we're coming, this is the beginning of the spring. Trees are just starting to bud, so it's kind of barren looking right now. This is site 34, this is a night site. And a lot of, because it has so much trees, a lot of these sites are very well shaded. One thing I did notice about this campground is, they're full hookup spots, so you don't need a dump station, but the dump station is across the street if you need it. And that was, we went around the entire loop, and now we're going back again because we didn't go down the road where we're camped at. So this is 2, 3, 4, 5, across the street, 6, there's 6, 7 where the Cedar Creek is, and then 8 is across the street on the right. There's the showers and the restrooms. And then if you turn down this, we're in 10, which is right straight ahead there. That's a pull-through. We got one of the pull-through sites that they have. 1 out of 3. The one right in front of us that's empty is also a pull-through site. Very nice and shaded and very level and paved.
And that's a little tour of our campground that we're staying in here at Redman Creek West Campground. Like Debbie said, this campground has 40 sites in it. All sites are full hookup sites.
Redman Creek East has sites 41 to 109. And there too, there's not very many. I think they only have 2 pull-through sites out of the sites that they have there. So,
we'll talk to you in a little bit.
Bye-bye. Of a mile one is kind of has some steep grades to it, so if you want to take the short one that's more flat, then keep to the left. See you later. Okay, this is Lost Creek Nature Trail, which is about 5 miles north of Wappapello Lake. This is a 1 mile loop, and it has been designated a wildlife refuge area where if you take this trail, you're more than likely to see some wildlife. And somewhere on the trail is a lookout where you can see the lake from the highest point. Okay, this is Johnson Tract Trail. We probably won't make this today, so we're just taking a video picture of it. This is a 5 mile primitive national recreation trail. And it's 18 miles north of Wappapello. As you can see, the weather is kind of overcast, so we're going to get back to the campsite before it starts pouring rain.
This is Lake Wappapello Wildflower Trail and Greenhouse. Now, it's not open this time of year right now. They have a nice little walk area here that you can see all the wildflowers and so forth that's on this side here. It's supposed to be really nice for viewing. And then on the inside, I don't know if you can see much, but they show you what all of the seedlings do and how things are progressed and planted outside in the trail.
A large family picnic or gathering. And you can reserve them. This is one of them here. You've got a big pit, water available. Oh, look, they got a permanent cornhole.
Permanent cornhole.
Yeah, pretty cool. Big playground. Yeah, this would be very nice. And then the spillway is over there. Of course, there's no water going over it right now. But I guess when the lake gets really full, that spillway can filter water over it. We got out and walked around that last time we were here.
This boat launch.
Rodents in the water, I would say yes. If you don't have a boat, you can park your car or your truck here, and then there's steps to go down. I don't know if we can catch it with the camera in the car. If you pull up closer to there, you can see there's a shot of the spillway, the water coming underneath the road, spilling into the overflow area here. It's coming in there pretty good. I imagine tomorrow, oh man, it's gonna really, they say we could get 1 to 2 inches tomorrow. And as far as a time frame, this is the 28th of March today.
2022.
Yep.
Wow. Wappapello Reservoir, Redman Creek Recreation Center.
Yeah, I think, I don't know, it looks like it might be open. I was going to say the visitor center is right here, and I thought it was closed. It is closed. It doesn't open, I think I saw, till the 1st of April, maybe.
Yeah, we brought the dogs up here last time we came.
Yeah. Yeah, right behind the visitor center, there's a beautiful viewing area. You walk behind there, and it's tiered, I think, also, but you can walk a little bitty, short trail and view the lake and the spillway. It's really neat back in there. And if you're camping at either Redman or Redman West or East, there's no launching fees. It's included in your camping fee.
This is one of the shelter areas here at Lake Wappapello. And as you can see, we're going upon the SS Wappapello. Nice little playground here for the younger kids. And you have the ranger sitting over there. Windy out here today, but that's okay. Interesting things for the kids and grown-ups alike. That's where the water's going into the spillway. Lake Wappapello, folks. Nice. Mushrooms of the area that we're at right now. Oh, nice and warm in here. Clean. Bathroom. Nice and clean. At Redman Creek Corp Engineer Park, we have T-Mobile on our phones, and we are running about 4 to 5 bars depending on where you're at in the park. The TV, over-the-air TV, we got 11 to 16 channels on that, viewable channels. So not too bad, not too bad at all. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up, and we hope you have a great day today. Stay safe, and may the good Lord take a liking to you.
You and me were meant to be.